you, and what a challenge to speak after Peter. I would like to take these 2 minutes to give you a few ideas on how to reduce trade barriers and reduce barriers within Europe. And this comes from, I guess, three types of actions we shall do. One is on the policy-making side, and I see the next step is to make the labor market more of a single market. And clearly on the policy-making side, there are still countries that have weaknesses on having a common language to use, English, and thus that's also another area that we need to focus on. The second area that is kind of my rocket, in a way, is what associations can do to try and reduce these barriers. And I have to say that I've invested about 20% of the past 5 years of my life working on young entrepreneurs platforms to support and have opportunities for networking. And I have to say this has to be increased even more, and the networks of networks need to be even strongly promoted. Also, associations of young entrepreneurs like ours, I come from an Italian large organization, have to work with other organizations to support bilateral and multilateral projects. And on this specific topic, I would like to focus on one that is Erasmus for Young Entrepreneurs, which is a very, very potentially extremely successful project that requires the support of associations like ours. I have not been on a rocket yet, but I have to say that these platforms do work. I think we did something like rocket science in a way when we managed to get a guy from Kosovo to join one of these platforms in Egypt. At the time, Egypt wasn't recognizing Kosovo as an independent country. And as another example of incredible things that these platforms can make, we were able to organize a bilateral meeting between young entrepreneurs from India and Pakistan, and this is another great example of where these platforms can take us. And to conclude, on an enterprise level or at an individual level, I wanted to show and share with you my three fights. I fight on three things. One is the word domestic, one is the word equipollence, and the third is the word networking. First of all, domestic. I want to ask your permission to ask you a question. I would like to ask you who makes business internationally. Raise your hand. Who does make business internationally? Okay, thank you. While answering this question, did you consider other European countries as internationally? If so, please raise your hand. Okay, there is a lot to work on, and this has been my fight in the last 3 years. I was finally able to have my company speak about Europe as a domestic market and when we are going to Indonesia as internationalization strategies. So this is my first fight. Second fight, equipollence. Very non-sexy Latin word, which basically means a directive that is enforced in one country in a way correctly, shall be enforced in the same way in any other country. The more we travel across European Union, the more we see that this is not happening. We need to fight for this to happen. And the third, and last but not least, my third fight is about networking. We need to become professional at creative networking. Networking is a three-stage event and phenomenon. We need to learn who we are going to meet, and having the profiles of people attending this conference was a great instrument. Second, we need to be very good at the face-to-face phase. And last but not least, and this is my closing remark, please follow up on the networks you are building these days, because you never know in the next 5 years whether you'll be the guy on the rocket Peter is building. Thank you.